What about Devin Haney?
He's a runner, so I'll give him about 5-6 rounds, you know, just because he runs, just like the way that we didn't expect Lomachenko to do, but he came in, he ran the whole fight, so, you know, my son got power, and people don't understand what level my son is in right now. He's at 135, but he punches like a super welterweight, so right now we just getting ready, you know, take care of this business we got with Gumbosis, and then move on, you know. We could get the Devin Haney's, we could get the Josh Taylor's, whatever comes into our circle, because, you know, I believe in God, and God is making this whole thing happen, so whatever he puts in front of us, that's what we're going to do.
Still champion at WBC.
Listen, the only reason why Lomachenko didn't fight him was because he outpriced himself, and another reason why he did that was because Lomachenko wanted to fight the winner out of Comey with Lopez. You know, that's a real champion right there. You know, I don't take nothing away from Lomachenko. I think he's a great champion, and I think he wants to fight the best to show the whole world that he is the best. You know, he just couldn't beat my son, and that's, you know, the bottom line. But, you know, for me, one of the realest fighters out there right now is Lomachenko, and I think that he's going to dominate the 135 weight division once my son comes out of it.
What about Josh Taylor and Teofimo? How do you see this?
It's already, like, talking about, like, you know, my son has unsettled business in the 135 weight division, which I think that's ridiculous, you know, because everybody knows that we beat the man to be the man. So, you know, my son is an undisputed world champion, without no doubt, and he knows that. So, you know, two undisputed people going together, that will be a big, big fight, and he knows it. A lot of money involved. So if he doesn't want to fight my son, it's because he's scared of my son. You know what I'm saying? That's all I got to say.
Another lightweight that already has moved up to 140 is Tank Davis. What about Teofimo and Tank eventually at 140?
Well, Tank right now is fighting a guy named Barrios. I don't know who he is. I never seen him fight. You know, so he's moving up to 140. That's good news to us, because we're trying to move up to the 140. So let's see if Floyd lets him fight with my son. Let's see. You know, but he doesn't look too, like he wants the fight to happen. You know, he already said that he needs a tune-up fight for Tank before he fights my son. So that shows you a lot, you know. And then he wants to be the A-side. You can't be the A-side when we're about to sell 37,000 seats at the Miami Arena, you know, in Miami. So, you know, you can't call yourself the A-side when my son is going to show the whole world that he filled up a whole stadium on pay-per-view. You know, Tank only did, like, what, 150,000 people watch that shit? I mean, and when you're on pay-per-view, it don't mean that you're a pay-per-view star. You got to make the numbers, and he didn't make the numbers when he fought. So what I'm saying is that this fight is going to show the whole world who's the real king. And, you know, and my son is always going to be on the A side.
You know, when Elisek Beck was here on Tuesday, he asked some kids that were here, they're like, if Teofimo Lopez would do an exhibition fight, who would you want to fight? And Teofimo chimed in and said, Floyd Mayweather. What do you think about the exhibition?
That would be amazing, you know. Like I said, man, I just let God guide me to where we got to go to. And if things like that are basically made, I mean, I think that would be a better fight than the Logan fight that he's fighting right now. You know what I'm saying? So, you know, it would be a blessing, you know, because I always looked up to him. You know, to me, he was a big mentor to me. You know, he got me. He guided me to do what I'm doing right now. So I can't take nothing away from Floyd. I love him, you know, even though, you know, he talks bad things about us, but it's okay, you know. Because, you know, he knows that we're getting to that level, you know. And it probably scares him, you know. I don't know what it is, but, I mean, we always have love for him, you know, no matter what.
Canelo might be fighting Caleb Plant, who also trains here at the gym. Break down that fight.
Listen, Caleb Plant is a great friend of mine. He's always here in the gym, City Boxing. And I see that fight, maybe a 60-40. I give Caleb Plant a little, like, maybe 10% more. I mean, I give Canelo 10% more because of the power and the chin that he has, you know. And I don't see that power in Caleb Plant, but I think that he could outbox the shit out of him. And if he could handle him for, like, 12 rounds, I think he will win the fight, you know, talking about Caleb Plant. But Canelo's ruthless, man. He just keeps on coming. You know, he got a great chin, and he's a great boxer. So, to me, I got Canelo 60-40 in favor of Canelo.
We have Rolly's dad here.
Oh.